Thank you for watching, liking, commenting, sharing, and subscribing right now.
There's a guy in the chat room right now who hates pizza.
Pizza?
Yeah, he hates pizza.
I wish we had that issue. If I could choose one food to hate that would save me so many calories, it would be cheese.
I like love cheese. Cheese. Oh, I love cheese. The only cheese I don't like is sheep cheese.
Ugh. Most Asian people, my aunt and uncle, can't stand cheese because they never had cheese, you know? And I wish I had been born with that, but unfortunately, I get that from my
mom. You wish you had been born with cheese?
Well, they have a situation with cheese. They have a lactose intolerant thing.
Oh, okay.
And then they never had it when they were kids because in Asia, you don't really eat cheese. Yeah. So they never liked it.
Yeah, but he doesn't like cheese. Really think it could be the brand? Oh, wait. You've only had Chi-Chi's? Cece's?
Cece's?
Oh, wait a minute. Wait. Ash TR, how old are you, and what part of the world do you live in that you've only had one brand of pizza? Seriously. I mean, like, I've had every brand pizza I can possibly think of.
Well, you're Italian!
Yeah, but it doesn't mean anything. I'm American.
No, it does mean something.
No,
it depends on where you grow up.
No.
How
where's
you
he at?
Fed.
In Texas? They've got to have other places to eat pizza than that in Texas.
Yeah, I'm sure they do, but that if your family doesn't eat a certain thing, then you just don't
How can a family
it.
Not eat pizza?
Well, I'm sure in the Philippines people say, how can a family not eat balut?
Oh.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, guys, what is your top five or bottom five foods you can't stand?
Have you seen people in Japan eat the octopus that's still alive?
Yeah.
It's still alive, and they
wrap
around the chopstick.
Yeah, and they twirl around. Yeah,
and people have almost died because they start tentacling you on the way down.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
I would die.
Well, but they like it. I've had octopus, but never live.
What about that one that could kill you? Was it pufferfish?
Fugu.
Is it pufferfish?
No, it's blowfish.
Blowfish.
I haven't had that, although I will have it before I die.
Unless you die having it.
No, it's not going to happen. I'm only going to go to, like, someone... Well, because you have to be, like, specially trained to serve it, the blowfish. I think it's... I'm pretty sure it's fugu.
Kat, do you like sushi? Have you tried it?
Kat will have sushi when she comes out here.
Are you going to try it with us, Kat?
Kat would answer, but I'm muted, aren't I?
No.
I unmuted
her. Oh, maybe not.
You better not mute her.
I muted you.
He muted both of us earlier.
Butthead.
Beavis. What does that make you?
Butthead.
All right, anyway. My top five list of foods that I can't stand, like, that I've tried, because it doesn't count. You talk about octopus, but you never had it. So you can't say that you don't like it because you haven't had it.
No, I'm just saying it's one of those foods that
it may not be.
I could do.
Right. Well, mine are chitlins. I've had those. Have you?
No.
Dude, okay. Number four, Brussels sprouts. Three, beets. Two, peas. And one, corn.
I had those pickled eggs that look like they've been sitting for, like, years and that...
Why?
People eat that in the South, and I tried the pickled egg, and it was disgusting.
Well, yeah, especially...
But I've never tried the pickled pig feet.
The what?
They're pickled pig's feet, I'm not lying.
Who on this earth thought...
Oh, in the South, they love it. They love pickled pig's feet.
That's big-time stuff.
I just could never try it.
Why?
Some people really love it. I just can't stand it. I couldn't stand the way it looks, so I could never eat it.
But the foods that you've eaten. I need a top five foods that you've eaten.
The pickled
eaten that
egg, I hate it.
Okay, that's one.
The kimchi, I hate it.
Okay, two.
I don't really like octopus when we went to go eat it at sushi.
Well, yeah, but you haven't had
it.
Yeah, but
the
that...
urchin I hated. The sea urchin?
Urchin.
Oh. Uni, yeah.
Sea urchin is disgusting.
Well, it depends on how it was prepared.
No, I didn't like it. I like it with
quail egg. That's good.
No, I don't like it. So that's one of my things.
Okay, so that's four for you that you've had that you can't stand.
Peas I really don't like. It has to be a full mouth of green mushy pea. Like, if it's a pea pod, I can eat it. If it's one or two in
pod.
Fried rice,
can't
I can eat it.
Can't do it.
But, like, a whole mouthful of just English peas...
Can't do it.
I just gag.
I don't like peas, like, 99% of the peas out there, especially, like, when they're in things. Wasabi peas are the only way that I can tolerate the pea. But that's as super dried and super saturated with wasabi.
So totally different.
Well, I know. It is. It's completely
like a
different.
Nut and a piece of corn.
Right. That's why I say I like corn nuts. I love popcorn, but I can't stand corn.
I know.
Growing up in Iowa, cannot stand corn. You, being part Thai, cannot stand curry.
No, I love curry, but it took me a long time to get to that. I used to hate cilantro, which is called pachi in Thailand.
Yeah.
But it was only because I had never been exposed to it. In North Carolina, you couldn't get cilantro because there wasn't a big population that would eat that, so they didn't bring it in.
He doesn't like pizza.
But then, now that I've taken time to eat it, same thing with avocado. I never had it when I was little because we never had it. But when I moved to California, then I became exposed to it. Everybody eats it, and so I started
trying. Those are like me and sushi.
Yeah,
I didn't have it. I definitely did not have that growing up in Iowa.
I didn't
but
like
I love sushi.
Until I met you.
Dude, I love sushi.
That's funny.
But it's got to be good. You can't just like go into mall sushi and go, "Oh yeah, I'll take that."
No.
I'll take
it. Has to be good.
It's got to be good. Like the chef has to like there's a chef that we go to. He used to be a sumo wrestler. And that's like some prime stuff there.
Yeah, are you going to try the sushi cat?
She'll try it.
You said yes or no?
She'll try it. We'll keep
Yep, I'll try it.
She's going to try it.
Now Kat, what are your
It's
least...
not on my five list.
What's on your five list?
Let's see. Mine would have to be sauerkraut.
I don't like that either. I agree.
Beets.
Beets.
Agreed.
The icky salmon patties my mom used to make from the really cheap canned salmon.
I could see that. I could see that being gross.
I love salmon.
I have tried octopus. It's disgusting.
I didn't like
don't
it
do
either.
It.
Well,
maybe
my number one.
What's your number?
Just the thought of it literally makes me gag. Is Brussels sprouts.
Cat's number one hate is Brussels sprouts.
Why'd you hold up the feed bag?
My stepdad used to force me to eat them, and I just I can't stand.
Oh, you know, actually, I don't know. It's a beverage that I can't stand. Milk. I can't drink milk straight.
That's true. You don't ever
drink. What?
I can't drink. I can drink chocolate milk because it's a different flavor.
You'll have soy milk.
I can drink soy. Well, I don't drink soy milk, but I prefer soy milk and like cereal.
But you'll eat ice cream. So.
I like ice, but it's not like I don't have a problem with dairy.
Probably six glasses of milk a day.
Do you really, Kat?
You know what? Here's the thing. Human beings.
I love it.
Human beings are the only mammals that drink milk past like the point that they need to.
Past them.
Right.
That's
the point that you
Did
need
you
to stop drinking milk.
Take
Human
a
being, it is unnatural, Kat, for you to drink milk. That, of course, it's equally as unnatural for me to take in half the things that I do. Coffee. Well, coffee's a natural substance.
Did you know that, though? Did anybody in chat know that? I didn't know that until Chris told me that.
Well, it's true.
I didn't know it either until he.
That's why
me.
I don't believe the whole you have to drink milk thing. I don't believe
that.
But
see, for women, there is a difference. Women need calcium, and that's
yeah. But
the best
okay, wait. Time out. You can get calcium from a variety of other
but
sources.
But we can get it from vitamins.
Right.
You
well, it's not just that, but your food,
different.
Like you know, beef has calcium in it.
But not the amount, especially
yeah, but, okay.
after menopause. We're
Ponzi,
not
do you
yet,
think
but...
Mother Nature would have thought of that? The Mother Nature would have had you breastfeeding until like. Every mammal on the planet would have been breastfeeding until death. If they, I'm telling you, it's absolutely unnatural.
Well, we don't drink human milk; we drink cow milk.
Right, making it even more of an abomination.
It is different, and it's different.
That's what I'm saying. It's like if I'm going to drink it, if I'm going to drink anything milky, it ain't going to be milk.
Which kind do you drink, Kat?
2%.
That's the one I like too. I can't go to the skim
milk. Yeah,
skim milk's too watery.
It's like blue.
And whole milk just icky.
Whole milk's too fat.
But you don't. But you're not.
I know.
It's.
I'm trying to get to the 1% because they say if you slowly go down, you can do it. But I just can't.
It's unnatural. You guys are not toddlers.
Oh, I like the.
Wean yourself.
Organic too. That's the one
I just
drink.
Like it.
Ugh.
Fiber optics guy. I agree.
I drink more water than that though. So.
Ugh. Ugh. Ugh.
I don't like the goat's milk. I don't like goat's cheese either. Goat milk cheese.
Oh, well, goat cheese isn't bad.
It's really different tasting. It's got a real pungent flavor that just doesn't agree with me.
Like,
I didn't realize how much milk I used until Jake, who is allergic to milk, would come over to the house And I use it, like, when I make beef stroganoff or just when I'm making sauces. And I use milk in so many things, and he is actually allergic to it. He gets sick, like, loopy, almost drunk when he gets milk. So he can't have anything.
Yeah, we thought for years we thought he was from the alien nation.
I'm allergic to coconut, actually.
You're allergic to coconut?
Well, that's good to know.
Yes, I get violently ill if I eat it.
I just get.
Gosh.
I get violent if I don't drink coffee.
The problem is I like it.
Well, don't eat it.
That's how I am with my morning Pepsi, Chris.
All right, everybody, what's your least liked foods that you've eaten in your entire life, foods that would make you gag? Go ahead and leave a comment or a follow-up. You know, I'm sure if you want to leave a video demonstration, you're more than welcome to do so. You know my email address. It's chris@perillo.com. Please do not email me photos of the foods that I can't stand. You are welcome to stop by the website with the chat room and the live video feed that is going on 24 hours a day. We're typically talking tech. Sometimes we do talk about food because every once in a while food floats across my desk. And, you know, as the case of the beet that Ponzi tried to serve me the other day, I did not eat.
Which was organically grown and local. And it
really?
Was the freshest, best beet that
right.
I could bring to our table.
Right. Okay, Ponzi. Now you tell
and
me
it
what.
Didn't happen.
Right.
I agree.
The beet that you said was good for me ended up coming out of your mouth after you tried eating it.
It was bad.
Right.
I tried to eat the green part. You know, I did it with a little olive oil, salt, pepper. Didn't happen.
Yeah.
It was gross.
Yeah. Yeah. It just.
Roasted it, turned my hand.
Not
going
to happen.
It just didn't work.
Not going to happen.
I steamed it.
You will never see
and
a beet
baked it.
On my desk, ever. And if you do, this isn't me. It's probably somebody else.
Agreed. No more beets in the house.
Thank you. We're at live.perillo.com. See you later.